गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, इस वीडियो में मैं आपके साथ में शेयर करूंगा दो मेन इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट। वन इज द प्लेगरिज्म और सेकंड की पब्लिशर आपका पेपर रिजेक्ट क्यों करता है। दूसरे पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से आप इंटरेस्टेड हैं किसी रिसर्च पेपर को लिखने के लिए, तो उसके लिए क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है, तो चलते हैं और देखते हैं कि प्लेगरिज्म और रिजेक्शन प्रॉब्लम क्या है। सबसे पहले जो पॉइंट है दैट इज दी अबाउट आइडिया। कोई भी रिसर्च आइडिया आपका छोटा नहीं हो सकता और कोई भी रिसर्च आइडिया को आप बहुत बड़ा नहीं बोल सकते हैं, राइट? तो रिसर्च आइडिया इज इक्वली इम्पोर्टेंट, तो रिसर्च आइडिया इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट और उसको हम जो कैटेगराइज करेंगे छोटा या बड़ा नहीं बोल सकते हैं। वट एवर कम्स इन योर माइंड दैट इज एन आइडिया। द इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट इज यू हैव टू जस्ट कन्वर्ट दैट इन टू दी इंफॉर्मेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। सो ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द रिसर्च, व्हाट इज ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ योर रिसर्च? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू थिंक, सम आइडिया कम्स इन योर माइंड, देन थिंक अबाउट टू दैट, यू डिफाइन द प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम दैट आइडिया दैट यू विल सॉल्व दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम बाय यूजिंग दिस आइडिया। नाउ देर आर थ्री डिफरेंट प्रोसेस इन रिसर्च बाय विच यू कैन डिफाइन द प्रॉब्लम। One is by using the experimental procedure, number two simulations, and number three is survey. So these are three different process to explain the idea, right? Now the third point is expected results. First of all, you know that about your idea and their outcomes, so imagine that these will be expected results from your objective, right? And then after result presentation, you will get some result, how basically you will present them in terms of the graphs, in terms of the figure, in terms of the tables, right? So these are different points to explain the or to represent the results. Right, next point is about result analysis. Remember here, in the beginning, I told you that I will focus only two points mainly. Now, result analysis. When you know about your results, then you explain them. But if you don't correlate your results with the existed results, then it will be difficult to consider them for anyone. So the analysis of your results, check carefully that who basically did this kind of work, and you have to use only the relevant research article when you quote the references. Why plagiarism? Now after that I will explain that what is plagiarism. Actually, in the last slide I told you about to the result analysis. In the result analysis, if you are not quoting the relevant research paper, then plagiarism software will tell you that this is the actual source. So plagiarism is nothing but plagiarism tell you about to the actual source, that people read a research article and at the end they observe some research references which basically are used in this text. What they do when they will write the research paper, in general they take an idea from this paper and quote the similar references in their bibliography. So this is the main problem actually, if you are getting my point. So what you have to do when you have an original idea, then search out the similar research article for that and you read them carefully. If you notice any idea from the particular research paper, you just define that, and that you have observed this particular point from this particular research paper, and then quote that at the end of sentence or in between, wherever you feel like. Good that this is the best position, but in general we use reference at the end of the sentence, right? So by this way you give the credit to the original idea which you have included in your research paper. Now the next point. If you are not doing this thing, then plagiarism software will tell you. This is the actual source, and sometimes plagiarism software don't tell you exact and they provide you a broad source, right? And then that time this is a question mark for you too. So my suggestion is, then whenever you write any research paper, then that time use only authentic, genuine. Then why basically editor reject your paper? Reject the quality in terms of that you presented is not up to the mark. What is it means? It means that your results are not compared with the existing results, or they are not similar to that, or they don't follow their trends, right? Or they don't provide any information, right? Further information of that particular area. So what basically a referee or editor do then that time, they reject the research paper because the presentation of the result analysis is not up to the mark. They are not providing the existing research articles and the trends or results in the same sense. So this may be one of the important points by which referee or editor reject the research paper. So provide only the relevant existing research article in your result analysis segment. So author as well as reviewer in the first phase understand that the idea through these results are representing some solution to a problem. So these are some points basically which I want to share with you, and already I have shared that a website at dimensions.ai. This website actually will help you to bring all the relevant and genuine research references for your research article. So if you will do this kind of practice, then I am sure you will get the acceptance of your research paper, and there will be no question of the plagiarism or rejection of your title.